Hello and welcome to all students in this my YouTube channel. Students, in our previous lecture we have seen the two quantum numbers, that is principal quantum number and azimuthal quantum number, and its combined information in the form of table. Students, in this our lecture we are going to discuss that thing in the form of increasing energy and size. Students, this is the table which shows n and lambda, that is principal quantum number as well as azimuthal quantum number. So let us see how this information, which is helpful for understanding these two concepts. Suppose students, if the principal quantum number has value n is equal to 1, we have named it as a K shell. It has the capacity of 2 electrons, means these 2 electrons will accommodate in 1s orbital. Now we will move to the next, that is principal quantum number has the value n is equal to 2, means which has 2 subshells in it, and if you look at its capacity, we already calculated with the help of 2n square formula. Total 8 electrons can accommodate in its corresponding suborbitals. So look at here, it has 2 orbitals, that is 2s and 2p. S orbital always have the capacity of 2 electrons, and it also has the suborbital p, means in p the 6 electrons can be accommodated, and in s orbital 2 electrons can be accommodated. So the total number of electrons are nothing but the 8. So this is the case for n is equal to 2, that is L shell. Now students, we will move to the next, that is if principal quantum number has the value n is equal to 3, then that shell we are calling it as a M shell, and it the total number of electrons in this shell are total 18. And these 18 electrons can accommodate in 3 suborbitals, that is 3s, 3p and 3d. So let us see how these electrons can be distributed. In 3s, 2 electrons are in, accommodated, and in 3p, 6 electrons are can be accommodated, and in 3d, 10 electrons can be accommodated. So these are the 3 different stages in which the electrons can accommodate, or this M shell has these 3 orbitals, or we can say the sub energy levels too. Now students, we will move to the n is equal to 4, and that shell is named as a N shell. It can accommodate in 4 different sub energy levels, or we can call it as orbitals, 4s, 4p, 4d and 4f. You should keep in mind one thing before going to learn this n is equal to 4, that is n shell. This is the way by which we can substitute the electrons in its corresponding subshells, that is s, p, d, f. These are the orbitals according to that the electrons are accommodated in its corresponding orbitals. Now look at this, it has the capacity of 32 electrons. Out of that 32 electrons, 2 electrons are accommodated in 4s, 6 electrons are accommodated in 4p, and 10 electrons are accommodated in 4d, as well as the 4f subshell or the sub energy level has the total 14 electrons. So students, this is the picture which shows us how electrons can accommodated in a different suborbitals. So this is the combined study of this data. Now students, we will move to the next quantum number. That quantum number we are calling it as a magnetic quantum number, and its symbol we have shown with the help of small m in the bracket. Now what this quantum number explains or this quantum number which provides what information. First thing is that it explains the effect of an orbital in magnetic field, that is the orientation of an orbital. Second thing is that the orbitals splits up into degenerate orbitals, which means that having the same energy and same size in a magnetic field. So this is the important thing. After splitting, which gives us the degenerate orbitals in the magnetic field. The third thing is that each degenerate orbital can hold up, which can hold up to 2 electrons. So these are the 3 important points which explains the magnetic quantum number. Now the relationship between lambda and m, means azimuthal quantum number and magnetic quantum number. Students, this is the very important thing for the filling of electrons. You should understand this table very clearly for filling up the electrons. Students, the first column which shows the information about the azimuthal quantum number, according to that its corresponding values we have taken for lambda is equal to 0. We have called that sub energy level as a S, that is we can say orbital S, and lambda is equal to, for lambda is equal to 1 we are calling it as a P, for lambda is equal to 2 D, for lambda is equal to 3 we are named that sub energy level as a F. Now students, corresponding M values also we have mentioned in the another column, that is second column. For lambda is equal to 0, here the value of M has 0, means only one degenerate orbital is present and the number of electrons in it are 2, means this is the capacity of number of electrons which are present in that corresponding S orbital. And after that, if lambda is equal to 1 and that orbital we have named it as a P orbital, which has the 3 degenerate orbitals, and that 3 degenerate orbitals are in the form of minus 1, 0 and plus 1. This is the magnetic field, when we apply the magnetic field to it, they will show the 3 values, that is minus 1, 0 and plus 1, and the number of electrons for its corresponding degenerate orbitals, means the number of in each each block there are 2 electrons are paired up, so the total number of electrons are 6. Students, if you look at the lambda is equal to 2, then that corresponding orbital we are calling it as a D suborbital, or we can say the sub energy level, and the degenerate orbitals are nothing but the 5, and the total number of electrons are nothing but the 10, because in each block there are 2 electrons are present which are paired up. And for lambda is equal to 3, the name which we have given is nothing but the small f symbol, and the its corresponding m values are minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3. Degenerate orbitals are now 7, and the total number of electrons which are present in that blocks are nothing but the 14. Students, look at this increasing energy and size. The same case is shown here also as that of the previous one. What we did in this picture, if you look at, for n is equal to 1, we have named that shell is a K shell and it has a lambda value 0. And the electrons are present in sub energy level R is 1s, because 1s is the low 1s is having the lowest energy level, so the electron will goes in the first 1s sub energy level, then electron will jumps into 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, 3d, 4s, 4p, 4d, 4f. So this is the sequence of what we can say the energy electron will enters into next orbital or sub energy level when the electrons are filled up at the lowest energy level. So the electron will goes first in the lowest energy level, then it after filling that lowest energy level, it will jumps into the next sub energy level or orbitals. So this is the block diagram of that complete table which we have explained previously. Students, we will move to the next quantum number, that is spin quantum number, which is shown by small s. Students, which gives us the information, valuable information, is that which gives the direction of spin of an electron, means either it is clockwise or anticlockwise. Electron which rotates around the nucleus also rotates around its own axis. Students, we have already have an knowledge that our earth will rotates around the sun. While rotating around the sun, it also rotates around itself. So this is the same case about the electrons. This is called self rotation. Students, whenever an electron rotates around its own axis, either it will rotates clockwise or an anticlockwise, 50-50%. Now students, for s is equal to minus 1/2, we can say that electron will rotates in clockwise direction, and for s is equal to plus 1/2, electron will rotates in anticlockwise directions. So this is the pictorial diagram which explains the clockwise and anticlockwise rotation, spin of an electron associated with magnetic field. Students, if you look at the orbital diagrams for a simple two electrons, we often represent an orbital as a square and the electrons in that orbit as arrows. The direction of the arrow represents the spin of the electron. Students, this is the first block which shows us the unoccupied orbital, and the second block we have shown one of the arrow which is in upward direction, means orbital with an one electron. And the third block you will notice here, that position we are calling it as the orbital with two electrons. So students, this is all about in our today's lecture. In the next part, we will go in detail about the filling up an electrons in a particular atom. So thank you very much.